Of course, the topic is understanding the current state of apps for supporting the effective diabetes care. And that is what is the topic given to me. And this is going to be the contents where I'll start with the introduction, WHO definition, health app types, which are the common ones available, then the short and long-term outcome of diabetic apps, whether any evidences are there, and the role of regulators and the guidance, ultimately, the appropriate role of HCPs, where the consensus report recommendations is a must. So diabetic apps are part of technology-enabled practice, which can help diabetic patients to achieve a position, clinical outcomes, and improve quality of life. They definitely facilitate the self-management of chronic diseases, and I'm sure all of us have experienced this in this pandemic of COVID from last 2 years. And of course, with the explosion of health and fitness apps and the rapid increase in the use worldwide, the WHO decided to publish a statement way back in 2011. And I'm sure from 2020 onwards, we've been having so many other apps and technology-based. Of course, Dr. Archana alluded earlier about the definition. It's a medical and public health practice supported by mobile devices such as mobile phones, patient monitoring devices, personal digital assistants, and of course, wireless diseases. This is what is a WHO definition for hem health. It can be medical devices and digital health technology. That is where we talk about today about the digital health apps. The medical devices, we know the CGMs, the blood glucose monitorings, and of course, pumps and smart pens, which are coming up now. So this is what in the last 3 decades, we have the evolution in diabetic management in particular. Now the health apps, three categories. One is the tracking wellness, standalone medical devices, and display devices, where we use data from the medical devices, which can prevent, monitor, or treat a condition like CGMs, et cetera. Now, look at this chart, which talks about 500,000 health-related apps available for wireless devices, which obviously smartphone-based, and the apps designed to help manage diabetes among these are most commonly available. So look at the numbers. It's 1,759, and this is what is available. The highest is for the diabetes management only, whether it is the Google Play Store or iTunes. It is the highest ones which are available is related to. Of course, the WHO has listed this eight most prevalent condition, out of which diabetes also is there. And of course, the small-scale studies of digital programs, which target glucose control, medication adherence, weight loss, quality of life, have definitely shown promising results. But the long-term clinical evidence is lacking because most of these apps are regularly being upgraded with a newer version. So that is why the long-term studies are still not possible, but definitely the short-term trials are there, especially with respect to the adherence, the glucose control with respect to the HbA1c. Even there are studies to show that the electronic medical records or the video consultations, which are there during this pandemic, has reduced HbA1c to the tune of 0.8 to 1%. Apps which are there available for diabetes management. One is a category name, the middle one talks about the definition, and the last one column talks about the examples. You can see the nutrition apps, which talks about the examples are the carb control, the food, LD, etc. Physical activity apps, plenty are there, but common ones are mentioned here on the right side. Glucose monitoring apps, again, Dexcom, Diabetes Companion, Diabetes in Check, all these are related to glucose monitoring apps. And insulin titration apps are also available, which are FDA cleared apps. Mind you, it's a FDA cleared app. One of the well-known is a Welldog Blue Star, which is there as a lifestyle modification tool as well. Apart from the monitoring of insulin titration, there is a where people can talk about their diet and they can talk about their other calculators like the basal bolus regimens, etc. And it's a FDA cleared apps. And insulin delivery apps, again, companion medical InPen, which connects to a smartphone via Bluetooth and keep a tracks of the insulin data. And the Dexcom Clarity sends weekly summaries and patterns identification to healthcare individual. Of course, Medtronic's Sugar IQ integrates the BGM and insulin dosing analysis in a close to real time. So these are all the apps which are available very clearly for us in real-time practice. And of course, now the closed-loop control systems, the artificial pancreas, like Medtronic's MiniMed 670G, all these are clearly available. So these are all the various segments in the management of diabetes we can look at now available, and most of these are free of cost. So what is the role of apps in the primary care setting? The primary care providers have to be familiar now with commonly used apps to advise patients with diabetes on their use of these products, especially in cities like metro cities like Bangalore. we need to be very, very clear, because the tech-based, tech-savvy youngsters, especially the 30s, 40s, year age group, we should be available, because this is one of the commonest questions they ask. And I encourage them to, especially in during this pandemic, my prescriptions of these usage of these apps, advice on these apps to the patients have almost doubled. And of course, there are limited randomized controlled trials, quad studies, because as I said earlier, the apps are being regularly updated, a newer version, so which limits the ability to check their long-term efficacy. The health apps allow the primary care providers to communicate about the glycemic data and improve health outcomes and quality of care of their patients with diabetes in ways that were not previously possible. And of course, thanks to COVID, which has definitely kickstarted and made most of our colleagues, fraternities, literacy rates among the usage of the computer has become definitely more. These are the summary of diabetic apps which are there. N number of apps are there. And the last column, HCP benefits. That is, for us as doctors, which are the benefits one? I have just highlighted these points. So you can see this, for example, it's a medical care recommendation, that is the ADA SoC app, which is Apple and Android. Most of these are available both in Apple and Android base, and most of them are free. At least the basic versions are free, like the MySugar, the basic version is free. And it's a wireless data pairing, medication and carbohydrate tracking, and HCP can get the reports, A1C prediction can be made. And these are all the advantages to the HCPs in managing. For example, in the high health glucose smart, which is both again Apple and Android, where wireless data pairing can be done and data sharing, secured cloud data storage is also given in this. And look at these other segments, like Dexcom is one of the things which is a real-time alerts can come about severe hypoglycemia, prediction alert, and rate of change alerts, data sharing. And look at the Freestyle Libre Link, which can remote patient monitoring via LibreView, standardized AGP report with CGM metrics included in the HCP reports. All these are the advantages for the doctor, where the real-time glucose values are updated every minute, literally. And these are free apps, and that's something very, very important whenever we are planning to use these apps. And of course, the diabetic diet app, you can see the healthy eating guides, etc., are given. And this Blue Star, which is the FDA approved, as I said, it uses artificial intelligence for the feedback, and it customizes reports and education. And it's again wireless data pairing that's very convenient for the patient, and where it can talk about the medication, the food habits, the sleep, exercise, blood pressure tracking. And that's something very, very important. And it can be connected to the team of our clinic or our assistants, and access to diabetes care and education specialties and electronic medical record integration. Our EMR can be integrated through. That's the best part of this. Blue Star is one of the commonly used, and that's something very, very useful in our routine practice. Of course, there is a glucagon app from Lilly, where simulation and use audio visual aid Good RX Saver are the two apps which talks about the prescription cost saving. Of course, it's not there in our country, but in US, it integrates a lot of medical prescription, and they will tell you which store is cheapest whenever you type that molecule, the trade name, and can give you that. Now, coming to our country, what are the apps available? These are the various apps you can see here, N number of them, MySugar and Beat Diabetes, OneTouch. These are the commonest ones which are used. And whenever you're advising these apps, you should educate our patients regarding the usage of this. And we need to tell basics about that. It can determine the glycemic variability, like high or low sugars. It can show your health behaviors, like the eating patterns, and help the overall management of diabetes. I think that we need to educate, the acceptance levels increases. Because now, whenever we see the very elderly, we don't. But usually, the very elderly come with their grandchildren or children, where we can again educate and make their life much easier. And this has definitely helped us in our pandemic era. And the Roche MySugar app is one of the commonest use. As I said, it's linked to AccuCheck, and this app is 1 million downloads in Europe so far. And it's about, in India, it's priced about 1,400 rupees. It can bring the connectivity with doctors and the caregivers and ensure accuracy in sugar level testing. And it's a Bluetooth connectivity, and the data sharing with caregivers and healthcare through PDF reports. That's something very, very easy and available both in iOS and Android-based technology. And that's something very easy, but it costs one time, and that's something we should remember. Lifespan, again, it's a complete package which comes with the great features like recording the blood glucose, blood pressure, diet, exercise details. They can update or input all these data, and the doctor can comment. And also it visualizes the sugar level fluctuations with the help of a graph, which is very easy to explain, or the patients themselves can see that, and that's how it can help. And this application has a provision to set reminders for medicine timings. And that's something very, very important. It can tune with your Alexa or other web-based things where it can switch on the lights, make an alarm, etc. When you make that reminders, it can remind about the insulin dosage and the food timings as well. And this application also allows patients to secure their personal data through the use of login account, so that it's a secure based and it's a cloud based again. And diabetes education is something which is coming up with the tips of lifestyle tips and educational tips regarding the management is what app will provide. And it's a every day getting upgraded. That's the best part of that. Now, the lifestyle app, Live On Go mobile app, is one of the apps which monitors blood glucose by linking to its associated meter to provide personalized insight into the glucose pattern and offers real-time support and expert coaching from diabetic response specialist via phone call or a text message. It's a case-by-case basis which is done. Again, this app includes the health nudges such as recipes, articles, etc. And it can store blood pressure readings and steps walked and allows users to order unlimited test strips and lancets directly from the app at no additional cost to the patient. So it's a home delivered. MyFitnessPal gives user access to database of about 11 million foods, which they talk about their nutrient contents, the restaurants nearby, their menu logs, etc. Of course, it's not in India, this is not upgraded. And of course, a barcode to scan for the packaged food, the calorie details. And combined blood glucose and lifestyle apps are one of the successful ones because it can talk about the dosing, the food, the exercise, the sleep pattern, etc. And uses artificial intelligence to guide and proceed with further management. The glucagon app is from the Eli Lilly, which is released way back in 2015. It talks about basically visual and both audio and visual. And there are some slides educating patients how to prepare and what are the precautions to be taken, etc. regarding the glucagon only. Now, this prescription cost-saving apps, as I said, the GoodRx and RxSaver, it's a number one free medical app available from the App Store and Google Pay. It talks about the drugs, supplies, and compare prices at 70,000 US pharmacies. It's not in our country. So they get coupons and the cost-saving happens. And that's encouraging for the patients to buy medications. And so adherence can improve. That's something very important. This is what these apps does, patient retention and adherence with the therapy. So non-invasive CGMs, quickly we will talk about these, which are going to be help, and some technology is going to be upcoming. Sweat-based glucose monitoring, which is going to be one of the game changers, and the presence of blood-related biomarkers in the sweat makes it a heart medium for non-invasive monitoring. So the design of a patch or a band type makes it possible for it to be a variable and continuous, and combination of other drug delivery modules can in variable sweat monitoring patches, which can be done like on the skin. And this is what is going to be in the future as well. And this sugar beet, which is already approved for use in Europe, it's a small peel and a place, of course, for 24 hours only. And this adhesive-backed rectangular transmitter sends wireless signals where through the smartphone app, with every 5 minutes, like this sugar beet can pick up and get the readings later on. And this Diamontec is something which uses a molecular spectroscopy, that is a light-based technology, to detect glucose molecules through the skin. Three varieties are available. One is called D-Pocket, the other one is D-Sensor, and the shoebox stationary ones which can be used in clinics. And this D-Sensor and D-Pockets are, one is D-Pocket is a handheld receiver that you press your finger on the on to get a glucose reading without any needle. And a small D-Sensor embedded into watches, which can be put into your smartwatches, and that can again give rise to the readings which you can monitor, and all these are expected in the next 2 to 3 years. So NovioSense is another interesting medium where this glucose sensor is kept under the lower lid, from where it can wirelessly send glucose measurements directly to a smartphone. And this Life Leaf is something, a non-invasive wearable wristwatch, where it can check not only sugars, but also BP, heart rate, sleep apnea, and more by using this sensor, which are already on the market in the Europe. And the iPhone technology is something where they're developing a sensor that would fit inside a smartwatch band to monitor blood glucose. And as per the company's website, it'll provide a real-time data and alert the patient to high and low sugars, as well as track other data. Spit test is something very, very interesting. In Australia, they've got a great funding from the Australian government itself, and they start manufacturing, and it will be in production line by 2023. That's what they say, wherein the researchers at this University of Newcastle have created a non-invasive, convenient and pain-free strip that checks glucose levels in the saliva. So if rolled out, a strip, that means a diabetic patient just had to keep this strip on the tongue, and they would, in few minutes, they would get the results on a smartphone app. So these individual strips going to be purchased in bulk in pharmacies for only about a penny each. That's the, it is going to be a very cost effective. That's what they're claiming as of today. Now, the common issues faced by the diabetes community are availability, evidence whenever this new technology comes, accuracy, the validity, technological issues, the differences among populations, appropriate role of HCPs, and of course, the role of professional organization. And finally, the data security and privacy in this era of digital media. So a series of recommendations are required to resolve some of these shortcomings. And these are some of the consensus report by the European Association for the Study of Diabetes and, of course, ADA, the technology working group, where they have told about the consensus report, the role of HCPs, like establish the standards, etc. Manufacturing companies should comply with the regulations, all that. But still, this is not applied completely in our routine practice now. And of course, it has given the consensus recommendations for the international and national professional societies should bring people with diabetes, HCPs, etc., together to facilitate digital health technology interventions. I think that is something all of us should embrace in this era of digital health. Finally, the mobile apps increases the accessibility of data for HCPs, because patients may access data from their smartphones, even if they do not have their glucose meters whenever they do the clinic visits. And especially in the pandemic era, where we do a lot of teleconsultations, I think this is one of the key methods to manage our chronic ailments like diabetes. And of course, new connected diabetic tools such as app-enabled insulin pumps, CGMs, smart insulin pens continue to become available more and more, and acceptance will definitely increase in near future. And this app space will thus continue to change and develop with frequent updates and new products. And these apps will become more customizable with the incorporation of the artificial intelligence algorithm to provide customized treatment recommendations and remote health coaching in near future. So thank you very much for patient hearing.